Today we're going to walk through making part recordings and rehearsal tracks for your choirs using GarageBand. My setup for this is an Apple computer and a digital keyboard. The digital keyboard is connected to my computer with a USB printer cable that allows the digital piano to talk to GarageBand and record in MIDI, which makes things much more editable than if you were just to record with a live audio microphone. In GarageBand, when you open it up, it'll ask you what kind of project you'd like to create. We're going to create a new project that is empty. So we'll select new project, empty project, and choose that here. That will bring you to the opening page of GarageBand where you can choose your audio track type. For this, since we've got the digital piano hooked up to the computer with the USB cable, we're going to select software instrument. That'll allow the piano and GarageBand to talk to one another and record in MIDI. So select your software instrument and click Create. It'll be important in GarageBand to have a setup that allows you to record each part individually. For this example, we're going to record a two-part song with piano accompaniment. And we're also going to create separate tracks for the piano intro, as well as a metronome click track that will be independent from GarageBand's metronome. So once you've created your first software instrument, my preference is to use the actual piano voice rather than a digital piano voice. So I'm going to go to my library and select piano and click the Steinway Grand Piano in the subcategory. That'll change the voicing over here. Now this would be our voice that we could record for the soprano part, but since we'll need multiple tracks, we're going to duplicate this particular voice. So we're going to go to track up top, open that and select new track with duplicate settings. That'll give us a track that we can use for our alto voice. We'll repeat that new track with duplicate settings for the piano intro, another separate new track with duplicate settings for the actual piano accompaniment. Sometimes if the accompaniment is more challenging, I'll even create two tracks for this. So I've got a track for the piano right hand that I can record, and then a track for the piano left hand that I can record separately. Lastly, we're going to create one more track that we'll use as our metronome click track later on. I use just a drum set or drum kit over here. Any of the available ones work fine as long as you've got just an easy, tight drum sound. So we'll take the available one here. That'll change that to our drum kit, which we'll then come back and use later. Once you have all these tracks created, I like to go in and rename them so that it's consistent for me what I'm recording. So you can go to the track, double click the name, and allow you to edit the title. So we can call this our soprano track. Second one we can double click and call our alto track. This will be our piano introduction. So this is all the piano that comes in before the choir starts singing. We can label that as our intro track. This will be our actual piano accompaniment track. I'm going to label that accordingly. You can even do left hand, right hand. If you have two different tracks, like I said before. And then this will be our click track or our metronome track. Once all of this is set up, we want to make sure that the parameters in GarageBand match what we're going to be recording. So up top, your tempo marking, you can double click that and edit it to bring it to either your performance tempo or the tempo that you're most comfortable recording at. You can record slower than performance tempo. And once everything's recorded, come in and speed that back up to your appropriate rehearsal track tempo. Your time signature can be edited here. The piece we're going to record is in 4/4. And if you'd like to change the key signature that you're recording in, you can. But since we're recording off of a MIDI keyboard, we don't have to change that. Here, the 1, 2, 3, 4, is your count in. It'll give you one measure of metronome count in before you start recording. And then here is an audible metronome that you can use while you are doing your recording. But then once I export the tracks, I turn that off. In the next part of the video, we'll record samples of each track. And then in part 3, we'll talk about exporting the files so that they can be accessed by your singers.